And we, the three of us, came into the film as actors, and he was also a producer. And Daniel was also an actor in the film. And yeah, we got to know each other through the short film. And then we decided to make a CD, or yeah, album. And when we had made the CD, we decided to become Gus Gus because somebody showed our CD interest, some record company.
It's the first album. Me and Daniel, we had been working in different rock bands in Iceland. I had been for 12 years, and Daniel for 8 years. And this is the first time we work together. And in this collaborative, as this work is, so basically what we wanted to do, we want to explore the electronic world more, because we were used to rock, the rock scene more. I mean, we're 9. We have so different ideas of how to do a song. It's not, there's not one way of doing a song. And for instance, this album is, that's the album I want to buy, because it's not this one song that is, it's going to be recognized or played, and the others are like the copycats of that song. So you get the variety. It's an adventure. It's something that you're taking to a new world.
Of course, it's not the easiest thing to be 9, but...
I mean, it sometimes works to our advantage even, because, you know, with the fact of being 9, nobody has the space to become the obvious leader, like often happens in a more traditional 3 or a 4 or 5 member band. So amongst the 9 of us, there is no hierarchy, and we just work on a equal level, and everybody just throws their ideas into the pot, and then we together select the ideas, and of course it can be stressful sometimes, but that's just the way we work. Basically, the focus of Gus Gus is music and films, where it'll be visuals on concerts or music videos or full-length feature projects. And then it's the variety of musical output. So on our shows, the visuals are completely imperative to the whole perception of the group. And we are trying to find the link between the musical and visual output of Gus Gus constantly. And they're basically, yeah, they're basically, you know, basically all of us have some input in the visual side, as well as all of us have some input in the musical side. So it's just not one person doing the visuals. I mean, we both do remix versions for other artists, and also we have other artists working on our songs. And also within the group, we do a lot of remixes for ourselves. So basically, in our mind, an idea is
never finished.
Never finished. It's, you know, you can work on it, you can add to it, you can, you know, bring new elements to it, and it's never final. It's always just on different stages, and it's life, the idea. So sometimes we come up with 6 or 8 or even 10 versions of a single song that we are making. And we don't necessarily think that one or the other is the right one. We just sometimes have to face the reality of selecting one for an album.
mein Fräulein. Ja! Bestimmt. Und das Himmel ist Feuer, ja!
I don't think we will do that. A full playback set? No.
Restless, you're 'cause you're in a chocolate kind of town. But if you wanna feel some good inside, hey big mama, yeah, that's alright.
And the festivals are of course a way to get a bigger crowd, and you know, and to approach a bigger audience. But our ideal settings are in a club, you know, which is relatively small, where we can put up our whole show and get the intimacy between the audience and ourselves.
I would never describe this music. I think everybody should listen and then decide for themselves what they think about it. The people don't need, you know, somebody to tell them in television what this music is and how they should listen to it.
Find another piece of wax.
Very important.
Very important.
Yeah.
Because there you see the whole picture, I would say. You see more or less what this is about. You see the music and you see the visuals. So it's like a movie with music and, well, and not that. It's more than that. It's like this world that we want to show.
Songs are different every night we play.
Yeah.
It's basically the elements are run through the big mixer, this big and Alfred work, and they mix it live and they mix it differently every time we play, and you know, it just makes it so much more fun because the dynamics of the set are different. They're always different and there's always something new and something different every night we play.
We're pretty much occupied until December, touring, focusing on the next single, maybe an album, got different things to look at. We have there's a film festival in Edinburgh next week that we are attending with two or three of our videos. Maybe the short film also. After that, I think we're gonna take a little vacation.
I mean, I don't think we made any serious plans for the future, you know. We just, while we're having fun and liking what we're doing, I think that's the most important thing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.